Welcome to the video. This video is going to go over what we're going to do in January, starting January 1st here, which is we have about 19 days from the taping of this video. And we're going to make a few little tweaks to this YouTube channel. The purpose is going to be much the same, which is practicing full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. We're going to make a few little adjustments to help us all, those who want to watch, everyone's free to watch or not watch, to practice this. I pointed out that the real remedy for our problem is a more monastic culture. Now, is some renunciate or monastic seclusive? Are they superior to like a lay monastic who's not renunciate or in seclusion? The answer is not necessarily, because if they're not practicing, then it's not better. No, it's the ones who practice that are getting it done. Okay, so what we're doing here is we are encouraging practicing. I've been saying this for quite some time, letting everyone know that at some point we actually have to focus in, tweak our lives a little bit and our approach so that fundamentally our focus is on actually practicing. And I've said the next 18 months to July 2016, it's very important that we be able to get very talented and very familiar with full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. Because our reality is just wow. That's all it is. It's pure freedom. It's pure perfection. Right now, always. All is eternal life. Always. And the realization of this is just a never-ending wow. And so there's nothing we need to do except get used to this, get familiar with it, move our comfort zone of familiarity in this direction. This is the whole secret to the path. If we don't do this, if we put on the trappings of spirituality, I'm a renunciate seclusive, and I have all these tapestries of, you know, religious tapestries, and I just do this, but I don't really practice full stop in the wow, then I'm just spinning my wheels. And more to the point, this world can be characterized by a genius of delay. The genius of this world and those who are, come here is the genius of what's called delay. And we're very, very, very much a genius in delay. But it's a non-necessary genius. There's no necessity to this genius at all. Whereas freedom, the genius of pure freedom, is a necessity. Okay, so there's a fundamental difference. And we can argue about it, and God knows we have wasted immeasurable amounts of time, almost immeasurable, playing and arguing with this. All a waste of time. And there are many who will continue to do so and continue to waste their time. Delay is unnecessary. The genius of delay is a non-necessity. The genius of freedom is a necessity, because that is our function that God created us with, and God's will cannot be changed. God did not specify any particular genius, other particular genius to us, that you must do this or must do this. Only the freedom, that's it. So we're using our freedom right now in working on the genius of delaying. Okay, genius of delay, in other words, rejecting our freedom, delaying the acceptance of our freedom, trying to deny it, and denying the setting down of the delay, and we're very much a genius at this. Okay, but this is not specified. God did not say you must practice this genius, or you must not practice it, or you must anything, but the necessity of freedom is our genius, and we cannot escape that. Impossible. We cannot escape it. Therefore, what does this delay really accomplish? Nothing whatsoever. Nothing whatsoever. The delay is based on fear of annihilation, but this is just a trick, motivational trick we're playing on ourselves. So, in short, We need to practice full stop in the wow. Full stop in the wow. And the more we practice that, the more we realize we don't need this to keep practicing the genius of delay. We acknowledge it's fabulous genius we've engaged. And that's all we need to do. Yes, it's been genius, but it's a non-necessary genius. And that's all we need to say. Forgive ourselves. Love ourselves for having practiced this for so long. No problem, no judgment at all upon ourselves. It's just we don't need this. It's not necessary. It's not necessary. We're presenting it to ourselves as if it is a fundamental necessity. This is not true. It's a mistake. It's a lie. It's delusion. It's self-delusion. Okay. This is what we realize. We don't need self-delusion to be what we are, which is freedom. Freedom does not need self-delusion. Okay? And there's no actual wiggle room here whatsoever. None. But we're so used to all this wiggle room in our genius of delay that it's very difficult for us to full stop, meaning no wiggle room at all, just full stop in the wow. But the only way that we ever get free of this self-delusion is to practice full stop in the wow, is to actually practice it. So this YouTube channel is dedicated to this practice, and we need to really start making a few tweaks to help us actually do this instead of just talking about doing it, which is the genius of delay. The genius of delay is, you know, just an incredible genius, and we're all experts in it, actually. Myself included, everybody here is an expert in delay. But we have to get past that. If we don't, then we'll be swept away by this genius of delay as it submerges us in agitation. There's a plan, there's a script for this delay that is playing out here in this world, designed to get us to embrace this delay, embrace the disempowerment of the movement. You know, it's like, let's empower the disempowerment movement, and this empowering the disempowerment movement so we can keep practicing the genius of delay as if it were necessary, as if it were fundamentally necessary, the will of God, which it is not. That is going to really coalesce, I would say, in July of 2016. So by that time, we have to be very familiar with full stop in the wow, so it doesn't bother us at all. In fact, we love it. And in fact, we feel this is home. This is home. This genius of delay will no longer feel like home to us. Okay, this is very important. Will no longer feel like home. It will feel like some bizarre farce, you know, that we're not really interested in. That more to the point that we don't even need. We don't even need it. So I don't need that. That's that simple. No judgment. Okay, I don't need that. This is not a need. What I need is to realize that I'm perfectly free and I've always been perfectly free. That I'm spirit. I'm not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. And that feels like home. See, that feels like home. So it's a question of what feels like home. Now, we are not attempting to make both feel like home. Okay, this is the genius of delay at work. We're not attempting to do that. One will feel alien and bizarre to us. The other will feel like home. Okay. So, we're choosing for peace and love and tranquility and the fullness of allness and an eternal life and oneness and pure freedom and the will of God. We're choosing. That is our home. Because it is. It is. We cannot make some other home. It's not possible. We're trying to. We're trying to use our genius to make some other home and try to make it feel like home. But this world is merely a house. Okay? It is merely a house. The universe is merely a house. It will never be a home for us. It will always just be a house. And sure, we can imagine we're dwelling in this house, but it will never feel like home to us, never. And so we keep delaying because we've deceived ourselves into thinking if we don't make this house a home, God will annihilate us, as if God gave us the function to make this house a home, some separate reality, as if God created us to create a separate reality, which is totally untrue. God did not do this. But we believe that as a motivational tactic. We tried to annihilate God, basically, change the will of God, and then projected that onto God because we couldn't do it. We said, uh-oh, I'm afraid I'm going to project this. So we think God is trying to do it to us. It is not the case at all. It is not the case at all. So have no worries about gently setting down this effort to make this house a home. It will always just be a house. Fine. That's no problem. You say, oh yeah, I played with this idea of a house. Making this house a home, which cannot be done, that's fine. That's part of the pure potential of all that is. We can play with that, and we could even play with it again if we want to. But not likely we will want to, knowing we cannot make it a home, and we don't want this feeling of being alienated from our home, do we? No, we don't. So, again, wherever you're at, if you're like a reclusive, okay, that's fine. If you're a renunciate, that is fine. If you're both a renunciate and seclusion, that's fine. If you're not a renunciate, that's fine. If you're not in seclusion, that's fine. Okay, all of that is fine, as long as you practice. If you don't practice, none of it is fine. None of it is not going to work out for you, because the plan in this world is to make the agitation so severe that your attention gets pulled away from trying to set down, trying to realize you don't need any of this, realizing you don't need it. It's just a house. It's not home. And we can play with infinite houses if we want to, and yet where we are always actually home, intrinsically home, in perfect freedom. There's no way that cannot be home for us. And there isn't, there are not two homes for us. There's only one. There's only one home for all that is, and that is God. Okay. So, practice. Now, full stop in the wow means just be quiet, because you're like, wow. So we do this in the videos. What I try to do is I try to trigger a wow, and then we just, you know, practice full stop in the wow. So this is how I see it. Is that there's some role, there's a role of triggering the wow. This can come from someone, or it could come from within, and then just full stop in the wow. It's that simple. It's that simple. And in this full stop in the wow, we're practicing letting go of our genius of delay. And just say, no, that's not it. Delay will try to creep in. When you're full stopped in this wow, delay, all our habits will try to creep in. And what we just do is we practice not struggling with that, not reacting to it, not struggling with it, just noticing it, remaining still, remaining quiet, remaining poised in this full stop mode. This is the intense practice, and a very helpful practice. We cannot continue to give oxygen to all of this genius of delay, even though it is an expression of our genius. Remember, the one true genius that all of us is pure freedom. And so using our genius of pure freedom to try to change this, it's futile. We can never make this feel like home. So we continue to suffer and suffer and suffer and suffer and suffer until we finally get serious about it. So what we're doing here is we're getting a little more serious about it, starting January 1st. A little more serious. Just a few tweaks. We're going to tweak the comment section a little bit. What we're going to do is, because we're practicing full stopness, we want to limit the amount of words we're using. Okay. So what I'm suggesting is, what we do is we simply make a simple statement of wowness. If we're commenting, and I do think it's important that people comment, because we need to practice simple statements. Peace be unto you is, for instance, is one of those. Is our thank you, our beautiful, our much thanks. This is like full stop in the wowness, an expression that it's very simple. Or just like, wow. I call this wowism. Maybe we're practicing wow. We're wowists. We're practicing wowism. No, it's not Taoism, it's wowism. And so, well, what we're going to do is we're going to start carrying over this practice a little more into actually our expressions, our reactions to full stop in the wowness, is make our reactions also full stopness. Now, we're not going to stop speaking altogether, because we're not going to be, you know, non-speaking. Some can be, that is fine too. But in our commenting, it's going to be, the guidelines are going to be like just a simple phrase. Simple phrase in some way, like, you know, and that's it. Practice the full stop there too. It's very important. And I may tweak the format just a little bit here, so there's some structure to it, which might be helpful. I'm not entirely sure about that yet. We will see how that goes. It can be helpful to help you realize that this is what I'm here for. To practice. This is what we're here for. To practice. And again, we're acknowledging the genius that we've been engaged with, the genius of delay. We've been very successful at delaying, okay, which is fine. No judgment upon that. This is what we wanted to do. We've had a hellish time at it, which has been rather interesting in some ways. But it's not quite the wow. It's not the wow that we're after right now anymore, okay? There's a certain kind of, like, it's not really a wow, but like, whoa! You know, whoa! You know, so the world's back saying, whoa! Whoa-ism! Whoa, but this is wowism. So we're going from woeism to wowism. Going from woeism to wowism. So those who want to keep practicing woeism, they're completely free to do so. Absolutely free to do so. In the appropriate venues. This venue here is no longer an appropriate venue for woeism, okay? Because this is now wowism, and that there is some discipline now that we're accepting to help us out with that. And you cannot practice both woeism and wowism at the same time. You just stagnate, which is a part of the genius of delay, of course. And we again are saying thank you to that. Thanks for all your great service. And now we're going to continue on with the play of our freedom, which is our fundamental necessity. Is our fundamental necessity. So, just a few little tweaks like that to help our focus. We have about 19 days to get used to that, And those who want to practice, it shouldn't be a problem at all. You know, the wowism, just all blessings, something like that. It's all blessings. Blessings of fullness upon everyone. So we need to begin to speak from the standpoint of the wowness, the intrinsic wowness of reality. It's an intrinsic wowness of reality. It's inescapable. See, so we need to start getting used to it. It's inescapable. And words don't really help us get used to it. All right, we have to go beyond words. Practice going beyond words. We're not abandoning words altogether. We're practicing going beyond words. So there's someone, because we're not abandoning words, there's someone who's going to be speaking. Now in this case, this channel happens to be what I'm doing. Now, I don't know if I'm going to continue that role or not. Baby, there's someone else who's even more adept at this. And they can have their channel, you know, on YouTube or something, and maybe we'll pay attention to that. I don't know how it's going to go. But there's someone who officiates, there's someone who, you know, uses the words. So there's some verbal structure, some conceptual structure, because we're not trying to stuff it or attack it, or we're practicing going beyond it. But we're not hating on our genius of delay. We're not any of that. We love what we've done. We respect it. We honor it. And now it's time to thank it. Thanks for being doing. Thank you, genius of delay, because I wanted to go through this, and now we're gently going beyond it. And this is called the fourth phase, So there's less verbal conceptual expression across the board, more silence, more full stopness. And more than that, there's an actual practicing of that, not in a rigid way, but with some focus, do you see, some focus. And whatever tweaks need to be made that are suggested by the Holy Spirit, these tweaks have been suggested by the Holy Spirit. And I know that they're necessary. And so January 1st, those tweaks will be in place. It's kind of like, for instance, in church, Vatican II abandoned a lot of tweaks, important tweaks. No more dress code, no more this. Well, what's happened is there's just been sort of a general collapse of focus in church. I've been monitoring this. What are the effects of Vatican II? And it's been a very negative effect in a lot of ways. You can argue this, but there's some, if you want to say, well, there's been some positives, fine. But there, I think it needs to be revisited, for instance, and some tweaks need to be made. This is just an example. So what I remember a little while ago, the priest said, look, we don't have a dress code, but you need to recognize that there's some things that are inappropriate, and you need to be aware of this, and this is not a nightclub, you know, because there are some people who treat it like a nightclub. And so that's just sort of a suggestion, but they're too afraid to go too far. That is something about the times we live in that people feel intimidated, you know, to say, hey, here's a few rules we need to follow. So just a gentle suggestion, you know, hoping that peer pressure, they actually said use peer pressure to say, hey, you know, if somebody feels somebody needs to be talked to, then say something. But they don't want to feel like they're too heavy-handed, because you know, they're going to lose a lot of a lot of people might stop coming, they'd be offended or something. So, but here, we have to go beyond this culture of being offended, okay? We must go beyond this culture of being offended. This is part of the genius of delay, which we're saying thanks, but thanks for the memories, but we're moving on from that. So, we are going to set some rules, absolutely. Just like I believe that there should be a dress code in church. You don't come in dressed like you're going to the beach. You don't come dressed like you're going to a nightclub. You're going discoing or dancing. You know, it's not a hookup place. You know, it's we're not running a fertility cult there, although there's some that are trying to turn it into that. And so you got to stand for something. Otherwise, ultimately, you will stand for nothing. And this is the genius of delay, is what's happening in the world is trying to basically eliminate the necessity of freedom, the teaching of the necessity of freedom, and the non-necessity of delay, trying to make it so that this distinction cannot be seen. This is the purpose of the world. delay is to make sure the distinction is not clear. So they want to get rid of all these helpful rules and guidance that help us make this distinction. They want to get rid of all of that. This is their purpose. This is the purpose of the genius of delay. Again, tremendous genius at work here in the world. But it's not a necessary genius. And this is the difference. And they don't want you to see the difference. This is what. So by July 2016, the world will essentially be in this condition now of agitation such that it can't see the difference. And therefore, if you do see the difference, they will claim that, well, you must be crazy because nobody else can see it, so it must not be there. So by that time, we will have to be comfortable, make a home with seeing the difference. Seeing the difference is our home. Okay. So then they cannot bully us at that point. Because if we think this world, we try to keep making a home of this world, which we can't, we'll feel rootless, you know, and then we can be bullied, for sure. We can be bullied. Whereas if we realize this world is not my home, I can never make a home of this house, and I'm comfortable with my home and the wowness of my home, okay? Because my home is just a total wow. If I feel like, yeah, you know what, I believe I can get used to my home again. You know, I can get used to it, the wow. Then we cannot be bullied. And this extends to all types of bullying, actually. The elephant cannot push us around, you see. We let the elephant roam around in its little, you know, rage around and wreaking destruction in its little, you know, area, but it saying, no, I don't need to be in that little playpen anymore. So we'll see if I can continue in this role or not. I'm not going to cut off comments altogether because that would be pushing it too much in terms of, hey, we're going beyond words altogether right now. No, because we need to practice. Trying to just force it causes a backlash, actually. Seems too difficult. I know a lot of videos just don't allow any comments at all, which I find, I don't like it, actually. I don't like it. Because I believe people should be self-disciplined and give the opportunity to express something positive in a short, concise way, like all blessings to all, you know, or thank you, you know, something like that. And positive, okay, it's a blessing. We're giving a blessing. We're not disagreeing or something. If someone disagrees, then don't watch the videos. It's that simple. Because this is a culture of practice we're doing now. This is practicing seeing the difference, okay? Being able to recognize the difference between what is necessary and what is not necessary. Ultimately necessary, fundamentally necessary, and fundamentally not necessary. And the genius of delay is fundamentally not necessary, whereas our freedom is fundamentally necessary. So being able to recognize the difference between a house and a home. Very simple. So the capacity to recognize this, it, again, is full stop in the wow. So the wow is all positive. There's no negativity about it all. That's why it's so wow. Okay, so the comments will be the practice. Comments are a form of practicing. So the comments will be practicing the wow. And the wow, it's so self-evident. It's just a very simple statement. Simple, concise. That's it. As Jesus puts it very simply, nothing real can be threatened. Nothing unreal exists. Full stop in the wow. There's a full stop in the wow. Yes. Or just yes. Just yes. But I don't want anyone feeling that, you know, there's no comments allowed at all. Because then we think, oh, we must stop words altogether. No, we're not ready for that. We're practicing full stopping in the wow. So eventually, you know, we'll even go beyond that. So like a dress code in church, for instance, it helps people focus in on quietness, and instead of being distracted when, you know, when people go up for the communion, they're all dressed differently, and you know, there's a lot, the way the dress is, a lot of people are drawing attraction to their physical appearance, their personality. Look how interesting I am, okay? That detracts from the overall focus and practice there. It's not about how attractive I am, how attractive anyone, how attractive the body is, how attractive this genius of delay is. It's not about that. It's about saying, yeah, I used to think this was attractive, but I'm realizing it's a non-necessary attraction. And the true attraction of pure freedom is a necessary attraction. Therefore, I must accept this and practice accepting this, which is full stop in the wow of this all-attractiveness of spirit, freedom. Okay, not the body. Okay, not the body, no. So obviously, if that's the purpose of what you're gathering for, which it should be in any place of worship, you want to de-emphasize the attractiveness of delay. You want to de-emphasize it. And it doesn't have to be draconian, you know, but it has. Does have to be. We do have to start getting used to some standards, absolutely. Some expectations. It's interesting, these times for sure. But even more interesting is our response to the times, right? That's what's really interesting. And being able to see the difference between necessity and non-necessity is absolutely crucial, because if we believe delay is necessary, we will most certainly continue on with it. Because we say, well, we can't drop it. Otherwise, we will be homeless. Because this is a necessity. They'll say this is a co-necessity with freedom. There is no co-necessity with pure freedom. There is no co-necessity with freedom. There's one and only one necessity, which is pure freedom. There is no co-necessity. And this is a wow. Delay is claiming it's a co-necessity, right? And just saying, well, we can make this co-necessity feel like home. No, it can't. It doesn't. No matter how many hoops it jumps through and gyrations it goes through, will never, ever, ever establish itself as a co-necessity. To claim it's a co-necessity is a farce, okay? It's a mistake. And how are mistakes corrected? By realizing we don't need them anymore. That simple. And because we have a familiarity problem, we keep feeling like we need it. We need it. So the only way to deal with this is to practice. Full stop in the wow. Wow. This is what Ramana Maharshi offered, for example, is for people to come, those who wanted to, attracted to this, to just come and sit in this wow. Just and practice full stop in the wow. Ramana Maharshi was just this big wow. Right? That's it. And he said, just, this is the way. Practice getting familiar with this wow. The attractiveness of our home. The attractiveness, the sheer attractiveness of pure of freedom, of what we are, is just this unambiguous wow. And so people would just come and just, they'd come in and just, they'd feel, wow. The fullness there, which we call silence, but it's really the full expression of freedom. Which needs no specific expression at all, so we call it, quote-unquote, silence. But it's actually, you know, fullness, total fullness of all expression. That is our freedom. It is there. And it just go quiet, the mind would go quiet, and just this, wow. And then from then on, it's just the discipline of getting used to this. That's it. It's that simple. For example, like in church, when you sit down, you're supposed to stay sitting. You're not supposed to get up and wander around and all over the place, you know. There was someone doing that last week who was a wanderer, but it's like people look and say, what's going on, you know, just ignore it, you know. Some people act out occasionally in church, and everybody just ignores it. The priest ignores it, everyone ignores it. And I'm just using this as an example. I'm not, that's it. And so if there is some acting out, just ignore it, just ignore it. Just keep your focus full stop in the wow. If someone acts out, it's just that it's too much for them, right? The intensity of the wow is just too much for them, and they've lost their discipline, their poise for a little bit. And how you can help them is just to maintain your poise. Don't argue with them. Don't say, hey, quiet, everybody, just maintain your poise. Pay in no mind, just stay, remain in your full stop. You have the right to do so. In fact, you have the necessity to do so. You see, we cannot escape the necessity of what we are. As much as we try, as much as we use our genius of creativity to try to escape the necessity of what we are, we cannot do this. And so we've been trying to escape for so long. The realization that we can't escape it is a big wow, and it's a big familiarity problem. Because we keep thinking that there's two co-necessities, and there isn't. So we have to eventually drop are functioning as if there were two co-necessities. This is an aberrational, farcical functioning that we're trying to invent. So the wow is, you can feel like being stunned or staggered or shocked or just wow. But the whole key is to keep it at wow instead of whoa, whoa, not whoa, but wow. This is the key to this phase of practice that we will be doing. We have been doing for quite some time now, but we will recognize this is what we're doing going forward. Not the whoa, but the wow. So watch your mind as it will throw all these woes at you, like, whoa, 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 whoa. Stop, whoa, 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 that type of thing, like, whoa, let's back away. And I say, I'm full stop in the wow. So I'm saying, not whoa, but wow, like, I love this. This is what I really want. And I'm just feeling continuity fear around it. But fine, I'm just letting it evaporate. So you're staying positive with this, and get, yeah. This is great. This is what I want to hear. But sometimes when the Holy Spirit is giving me clarity, you know, it's just fabulous. I say, wow, I love this. Don't stop, don't stop. It's like this flow of clarity, just as, like a breeze. Just this is fantastic. I love it. At the same time, I'm trembling and shaking because it's just like, wow, I'm not used to this. I'm not used to this breeze of clarity. But I say, don't stop. I want to get used to it. Come on, don't stop, don't stop. Keep going. Eventually, I feel like tired. You know, you get tired. It's again, we must be a spiritual athlete. Okay, a spiritual athlete. Where you realize you're going to get tired, but you say, this is great. I'm running a marathon here, and of course I'm going to get tired, but I love it. I love it. This is the attitude. You're not going to be able to run a marathon if you hate it. So, I hate running. I hate jogging. I hate doing it. And, I feel tired. I gotta quit. I hate doing it. You're not going to be succeed at all. Whereas if you say, I just love this. I just love it. Of course I feel tired. There's an ache. Oh, that's okay. I love it. I'm going to continue. And I'll be kind to this. You know, if my foot's starting to hurt or blister, I'll be kind to it, you know. And I'm feeling dehydrated. I'll get some water. But I'm not going to stop. I love this. See, watch people in marathons. They're like, yeah, it's tough, but I love doing this. This is the same attitude you have to have with this. I love doing this. So, like, one expression can be just, I love it. I love this. It's helpful for others to hear this. The others are saying, I love this. You know, I just love this. Love it. Of course it's tough. That's a given. So we don't need to have expressions of what's given. Like a marathon, of course it's tough. We don't need to people say, oh, this is so tough. I hate it. Everyone knows it's tough. So what they need is encouragement. Like, yeah. Isn't this great? Isn't this awesome that we're doing this? This is totally awesome that we're doing this. Totally awesome. It's a given that it's tough. It's already a given. We all know it. You see, so we don't need, you know, the negativity saying, hey, everybody, wow, you know, isn't this, you know, we're suffering so bad, you know, it's terrible, isn't it? No, hey, this is great. We all know it's tough. Isn't it great that we're standing up to non-necessity and claiming it as non-necessary? Isn't that great? Isn't it great we're finally taking on this challenge? Isn't that awesome? Isn't it great we're finally taking on this tough challenge and getting it done? Yes, yes, yes. That could be our motto. Yes, yes, yes. Full stop in the wow. Yes, yes, yes. Ain't it great? So, wowism. I'm a wowist. This is wowism, if you want to attach a simple label. It's just wowism. What's your religion? I'm a wowist. Oh, wow, really? What's wow? Full stop in the wow of our intrinsic nature. Full stop in the sheer attractiveness of our true nature. That's wowism. I've always wondered, you know, people ask, what's your religion? I've never been able to say, well, I don't know. I don't know how to answer that. But I'm saying, okay, I'm a wowist. Wowism is my religion. Wowism. So there's a little tweak, too. A little tweak. I'm going to attach a little label to it. Because it's difficult. I know I've struggled. You feel like insecure, like, well, do I have a religion? Yes, but what is it? I'm not sure. What's your belief? Well, I'm a wowist. Yeah. Oh, well, what is that like? Full stop in the wow. In the sheer practice and getting familiar with the sheer attractiveness of our true nature. That's what it's all about. And the necessity of that. Accepting the fundamental confession of repentance is realizing there are not two, there's not a co-necessity. There's only one necessity. There's only one necessity. And that's our true nature. Okay. And we recognize that. We're recognizing, no, there's only one necessity. That is pure freedom. There are not two necessities, just one. That's the confession. Not two necessities, just one. and the temporary discipline of overcoming, evaporating the continuity problem. You might call that a ancillary necessity, a pragmatic necessity to dump the idea of co-necessity, setting it down, setting it, thanking it, forgiving ourselves for playing with that, you know, idiocy, that silliness. So there's a pragmatic necessity in evaporating the continuity fear around the delusion of co-necessity in order to fully accept there's only one necessity, and that is pure freedom. So the full stop in the wow of the sheer attractiveness, the sheer attractiveness of true nature, of true nature, which is absolute freedom. So I'll be dropping some reminders in the next, I guess, 19 days. Just a heads up where we're going here with this. Practice remains the same as we've been doing for quite some time now. In phase 4, full stop in the wow. And as we practice this, what I've experienced is I'm catching little glimpses that trigger a wow. I said, oh my gosh, I'm free. I just realize I'm not bound by this. Wow. This is what happens. The more you practice, the more you'll just be driving along and suddenly you'll just click in your mind. You just say, hey, I just realized. I just had a glimpse of realization. Wow. Just had another glimpse of realization. So this is happening with popcorn now. You know, like you heat up popcorn and nothing's happening. You're watching the bag in the microwave. Say, wow, maybe these are all duds. You know, what's going on? Say, they said 2 minutes. But, you know, it's like a minute 30, nothing yet. And then like minute 45, pop, one pops. You say, huh. And then, you know, 2 minutes, pop, another one pops. Well, I don't know, maybe there's a few here. Then pop. Pop, pop, pop. Right? And you go a little longer. Pop, 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 pop. And then, you know, so many. And you go, oh, I'm going to get popcorn. That's great. It's very much like that. Is the more you practice full stop in the wow, there's little pops will happen. Like, ah. Just like that. Just like that quick. And you just recognize. Wow, I'm not bound by this. I'm not bound by nature. I'm not bound. Wow, all is eternal life. I just caught a glimpse of it. I just realized this. Caught a glimpse of realization. I spiritually saw this truth. I spiritually saw this truth about it. And you don't dwell on it. Just a little pop, pop, and that popcorn's popped. So once all this popcorn pops, you got a whole bag of popcorn that you can enjoy. Enjoy it, see? So we're just popping the popcorn now. That's all. There's a discipline. You don't stop the microwave, take out the bag, open it. What's wrong with all these kernels? You know, you have to have some faith. This pops the popcorn. Full stop in the wow pops the popcorn. Popcorn is popping. That is for sure. So I'm continuing on because for me, the popcorn is popping. No doubt about it. It's a little stressful because the world, cosmic corporate culture, doesn't want the popcorn to pop. It wants us to think that the popcorn duck can't pop. Because that's detracting from us making this a co-necessity, making this house a home. We have to work on that. No, we don't. Nobody has to work on that. It's not a co-necessity. This is the fundamental correction of the fundamental mistake. There is a fundamental mistake we are making in our attempt to change the will of God. We have to realize that is not a necessity. It's a whim. It's a whim that we forgot to laugh at. So all we're doing is we're just remembering to laugh at it, you know, to laugh with it and to say, okay, that's funny, next, you know. It's not a co-necessity. This is the fundamental difference between cosmic corporate culture and cosmic spiritual culture. Cosmic spiritual culture recognizes, accepts, knows there is no co-necessity with absolute freedom whatsoever. There's only one home. There are not two homes. We don't have two homes. We have one home, which is all that is, always. All is eternal life, always. And again, the full stop is in this. You can call it a feeling. It's not an emotion. So it's a wow feeling. That's the way I put it. Now, in our genius of defensiveness, you know, there's various ways, a lot of different ways we defend against it. We try to turn it into an emotion. Or an intellectualization, a conceptualization, an emotion, different. We have all different sort of defenses. Different people use different ones. They have their favorites, etc. The dance of defensiveness, dance of delay. But this is like a reverberation, a feeling of just wowness. That's why I call it wowness. I'm practicing wowness. I'm a wowist. I'm a wowist practicing wowness. And of course, when you feel this, it's like almost like a jolt, but more than a nervous jolt, deeper than the body, any body jolt. We try to jolt our bodies, trying to make a co-necessity thing. Hey, we can get the same jolt through jolting bodies, but we cannot. No, this is a deeper jolt. It's the jolt of saying, hey, I'm not a body. I don't even need a body. Wow, I don't need the jolt of a body. Wow. So, in trying to make this delusion of co-necessity, trying to make this house a home, which is impossible, trying to keep delaying and asserting the co-necessity of delay, you know, I call it the sex, drugs, rock and roll thing, of trying to jolt the body. And claiming that jolt is, this makes, you know, this is practice. You know, we're practicing making this house a home, practicing getting used to this co-necessity, you know, making this house, this so-called house of co-necessity, of delay, a home. That's what we're practicing, you know, but that's not what we're practicing here. We're practicing setting that down. So we're not trying to jolt the body with sex, drugs, and rock and roll at all, okay? We're allowing the spiritual wow of realization to jolt spirit. It's like, spirit is like, wow. The mind is like, wow. I don't even need all this nonsense. I've never needed it. There's never been any co-necessity. It's either the trick that we're getting past is to say, well, there used to be a co-necessity. Co-necessity is real, but we're getting rid of it. You know? As Jesus says, but the stumbling block is we think we need to make illusions real and then get rid of them. This is not true. There's never been a co-necessity of delay. Never been a co-necessity of delay. Of time, space, process, form, of disempowerment. There's never been co-necessity of disempowerment. Never. This is realization. The other is not realization. It's delay, the genius of delay. So the genius of delay is to say, yeah, it is a co-necessity, but we can get rid of it. Don't worry, God, there's a co-necessity. We did make a separate reality, but now we're going to get rid of it. Not true. This is delusion. It continues the dance of delay. So with that path, I use the jolting of the body, the nerves, the psyche, you know, sex, drugs, rock and roll, jolting of this is a cosmic corporate culture, that's what they're about. Here we don't do that. We set that aside. And how do we do it? By saying we don't need it anymore. Because the spiritual jolt of wowism, we say, wow, this is way better. This is what I really want. So let's not kid ourselves here about what we really want. There is no co-necessity of the genius of delay. That is not a co-necessity. It's not a fundamental co-necessity whatsoever. There's only one necessity we have, which is pure freedom. And so we're practicing the sheer attractiveness, getting used to the sheer attractiveness of our true nature, which is the singular necessity of pure freedom. There's only one necessity, pure freedom. There's only one God, only one necessity, only one allness. So practicing the sheer attractiveness of this wowism. I'm a wowist practicing wowism. The wowness, practicing the wowness. Full stop in the wowness. Full stop in the wowness. I'm a wowist, and my religion is wowism, and I'm practicing full stop in the wowness. There you go. There's a nice trilogy for you. So we've been gradually heading this way, being gentle, being kind, being tolerant, being forgiving, all of this, moving our comfort zone. That's all. This is where it's at. And those who don't do this will probably at some point be wailing and gnashing their teeth saying, you're not helping us, because we need to establish this co-necessity, and you're not helping us out. If we don't establish, we'll be annihilated. This is whimsical, silly, whimsical, delusional, projection, not necessary, continuity, fear, need to practice, that's all. And we deserve to do our practice. Everyone deserves it. So we need to set the example, not react to that. There is no co-necessity. We have just tried to invent a co-necessity, and we have no such power whatsoever to change the will of God. This is fundamental. And it's not just me saying it, it's Jesus saying it. We have all freedom and power, Sarah, except we do not have the power to change the will of God. We do not have the power to change reality. We do not have the power to change our function, one function. We do not have the power to change our pure freedom. We do not have the power to change the attractiveness of what we are. We do not have the power to disempower ourselves. And we never will. No matter how much our creativity plays with this plot with plausibility, all it's doing is playing with plausibility. Like in a sandbox. That's it. Building sandcastles of plausibility. And plausibility is just dualistically relative, right, to other plausibility. And cosmic corporate culture wants us to remain in this relativistic, dualistic plausibility, which doesn't have any grounding in necessity at all, right? Ignores this. And so you feel like you're lost, and you keep trying to jolt the body to get some sort of wow feeling, try to make this place a home, try to simulate the sheer attractiveness of our true nature, which is impossible. You cannot actually successfully simulate that. Cannot. But we keep trying, right? We keep trying to tweak, color correct the world, right? Trying to color correct it. Make precise cuts, scenes, color correct. You know, there's these video programs like Lightworks, and where you tweak. We're all trying to tweak, a bunch of tweakers in this world, actually. You know, so let's say goodbye to all the tweaking, you know, all that sort of tweaking. And then pragmatically, we need to make a few tweaks to let go of the tweaking. Just like that, all right? And that is, we can't continue to be full blast tweakers, okay? So, we say, we're not going to abandon tweaking altogether, but we're going to use tweaking in the right way. So let's make a few tweaks here. To set down tweaking. And the world is becoming a bunch of tweakers, aren't they? Which is a word describing methamphetamine abusers. tweakers, you know. It's also used a word. They're trying to tweak themselves, trying to get the wow, you know. The wow of the believed in co-necessity. But more and more the world, this methamphetamine problem is sweeping the planet, actually. It's not just in the Central Valley of California, so, you know, it's everywhere. It's in the jungles. All sorts of labs cooking up methamphetamine all over the planet, as a matter of fact. And people from indigenous tribes to intellectual elite, etc., more and more and more getting into it, tweaking. This is where people are desperately trying to hold on to this, thinking if they don't, they'll be annihilated, which is delusion. They think we have to establish this as a co-necessity. So they have to get this wow feeling. They have to make it feel equally attractive to reality, which is completely impossible. But they feel they need to keep finding some way to tweak, you know, their experiencing. So, you know, these more and more drugs are coming on the scene, like methamphetamine. There's just a massive avalanche of drugs available in the world now, and there'll be more and more and more laboratories everywhere in the world cooking up all sorts of drugs, and people using them frantically, actually. Desperate to get that tweak, you know, to get that wow, artificial wow, physical wow, hoping to make it as attractive as the sheer attractiveness of reality, our true nature, which is spirit, which is the oneness of pure freedom of spirit. And it doesn't work, so they go to stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger tweaking. This is what we were warned about. Jesus warned us about this, saying that what will characterize the end times, actually, the times of collapse, really, into incorporation into cosmic corporate culture, what will characterize that? Pharmaceutical world, pharmaceuticals, drugs will flood the planet, is what Jesus told us. This is what we were told. This is what the Holy Spirit has been also telling us clearly. Now, it hasn't been translated properly, but an expert in translation, I watched a video once a long time ago, and he said the actual translation, the correct translation of what Jesus said, is actually that pharmaceuticals will be a pharmaceutical world. A world flooded with drugs. And this hasn't been translated correctly, actually. And I'm not going to get into, I don't remember who it was or whatever, but I accept it. I believe what he said was right, correct, and empirically, it is absolutely correct. Okay, that's good enough. This is what's happening. And we know why it's happening, you see. And there's some wow to that, saying seeing clearly is a wow. So that's why I still bring up talk like this way. Seeing, realizing, we are in the end times. We are in end times, meaning when the planet will be incorporated into cosmic corporate culture, which is a commitment to trying to make this house a home, trying to make a co-necessity out of fantasy, out of a whim, a commitment to that. And incorporation means you've been committed to it. You're committed to it. This is what the end times is all about. This is what the apocalypse is all about. This is what it's really about. And this is what's actually happening here. We're in it. And by July 2016, I've been told, warned by the Holy Spirit, the incorporation will coalesce and crystallize by that time. And from that time onwards, if you don't have a comfort zone with the sheer attractiveness of our true nature, then you're likely to be swept away into this this corporation, which is dedicated to trying to establish co-necessity, which is futile, ultimately futile. Futile right now. Ultimately, everyone realizes it's futile. But delay, the genius of delay, is proud of itself, and arrogant and proud, and it sweeps you along, like, wow, look at how we can generate an artificial wow. Wow, we're generating this artificial wow. Wow, this is going to work. Eventually, no, it never does. cyborgs, robotic culture, all the stuff that's coming, you know, all this supposed wowness, trying to generate a second co-necessity and a wow about that co-necessity. It's never enough, so it's always, you're searching for more, searching for more, searching for more. This is the cosmic corporate culture, always searching for more wow in order to establish this co-necessity. We're already co-creators with God. We did not establish ourselves as co-creators. God did. We can never be the ones who established ourselves. We cannot be the creators of ourselves, what we are. We didn't create our function. God did. God's the prime creator. So we're trying to create this secondary necessity of it's necessary that we be the creators of ourselves. No, it is not necessary. Maybe there'll be those who are inspired by these videos to start their own channel or do their own thing. Well, that's fine. That's fine. But we're going to keep this channel simple and focused. And if you know, go to where you're feeling the wow. So if there's some other sort of feeling like I want to watch something else or something, fine, do it. Whatever helps you trigger the wow and help you with the full stop in the wow. Absolutely, go do it. Everyone's free to come here. Everyone's free to leave here, like that. But while they come here, there's certain guidelines to follow. This is what we're doing, okay? This is what we're doing. This is the one who is using the words, and the others are practicing the full stopness, right? Just like, for instance, in the Mass, the priest is the officiant, okay? There's someone in the audience doesn't get up and say, hey, you know what? I feel like I want to be the officiant too. I'm going to come up here. No. It's understood. This is the one that's playing this role, and your role is to... You know, get whatever you wow, you know, full stop in the wow, whatever you can from that. Again, I'm just an example. So there's one officiant, not co-officiants, because that immediately, those who are trying to establish a co-necessity always feel that there needs to be two doing it, you know. No, only one is necessary. Because it's for the purpose of practicing and getting used to the sheer attractiveness of just one necessity. Sheer attractiveness of just one necessity, not two. There's not co-necessity. Okay, a little distraction. But I've said enough here. I've said enough, absolutely. So... just go over this video, maybe go over it several times. It's an important video. This is where we're heading with this YouTube channel. Full stop in the wow. So welcome to Wowism.